members of parliament on the East African Affairs and Foreign Affairs Committee were today heckled by South Sudan security officers as they conducted a fact-finding mission on the international border between Uganda and South Sudan in Elegu. At one point, it's understood that the confrontation became a little bit uncomfortable for the legislators, who had to retreat to the safety of the Elegu One Border Point building.
The members of parliament who feel they were humiliated and embarrassed in their own country are calling for an immediate demarcation of the borders to avoid a repeat of this.
Now, for how long are we going to call them our brothers when they don't consider us to be their relatives? And they are studying here. We are hosting them like refugees. No one for us in Uganda will really accept that they are our brothers and sisters. And they don't consider us. What are we going to do?
Then you should say there must be a recommendation. If we don't take this matter seriously, these people of South Sudan one time will even extend the boundary up to Karumba. And they say, Karumba, you are South Sudan. Because the way they are behaving sincerely, as government, we need to take serious action.
The two parliamentary committees of Foreign Affairs and East Africa Committee have visited the border post at Elegu to ascertain the level of insecurity. The chairperson of the committees, Boaz Kasirobo, noted that the countries cannot continue to have bilateral relations if the borderline demarcation is not resolved.
Our demarcation of our borderline between the two countries, it is also a matter that has resulted in two incidences of violence, clashes between the two countries, UPDF and SSDF, as well as the loss of lives of several Ugandans. Today, it is a matter of primary concern to the committee, and which we would like to discuss to different state stakeholders about the way forward of resolving it.
The Republic of South Sudan joined the East African Community in April 2016. Noel Nchise, the chairperson of the East African Affairs Committee, retaliates that anything that affects the border relations affects the East African integration.
As East Africa, East African Community, we know there are protocols that have been signed. The Customs Union Protocol, the Common Market. We expect free movement of persons, of goods, and property.
The Amuru District RDC, Ocheng Osborne Geoffrey, expressed fear that the country is failing to manage the porous borders, especially along the Uganda-South Sudan.
IDP camp is 3 kilometers inside Uganda. 3 kilometers inside Uganda, but South Sudan is saying that is their land. A government can never sustain escorting trucks. It's very costly. So it needs deployment and identifying the hotspots so that proper deployment is done. But escorting, where will you get the resources?
Between March and August 2021, 25 traders and East African truck drivers were killed in South Sudan. On the 22nd of August alone, 4 truck drivers were killed inside South Sudan. This prompted a 2-week strike by the East African truck drivers, which ended on the 6th of September 2021 after meeting between the two embassies.
Our commander-in-chief one time was there, he said, no, that one they will interact with the excellence of the other country. They come, foreign affairs, with you. You go with the GPSs, but of course sensitization. Because if you don't sensitize those people, however much you may say, this is South Sudan, you will not agree.
But the member of parliament believes that a time frame should be put in place to stop the senseless security threat from South Sudan.